This is my 100th episode of this show. 100th! So I got myself some balloons and cake. Go me. This week in Azure, there were a lot of small but significant announcements and changes. I've chosen the three most interesting ones. App services now support the .NET Framework 4.8. You can select which disks for a VM to back up, and a new migration path from Windows CE to Windows 10 for IoT devices. You've tuned into Azure This Week, the show that delivers the best cloud updates every week. Okay, maybe not the best, but pretty good. And we have balloons. The .NET Framework is Microsoft's number one and oldest infrastructure for running desktops and web applications. It is used by millions and millions of projects and services, and the latest version, 4.8, is now available for use on Azure App Services. While Microsoft advises to upgrade to this version for security and bug fixes, earlier versions will continue to run unchanged too. If you want to upgrade to 4.8 now, start with the official migration guide. The link is in the description. Backing up the data on your virtual machine is by no means a new concept. Hopefully, you are backing your right. Hopefully, you're backing your data up too, right? Right? Anyway, you can now select which disks are being backed up for each VM. This means you don't pay for backups of all that temporary data that is created at times, as long as it is on a separate disk. This also means that backups and restore operations can be much quicker, as only the needed data is processed. This applies to both restore from snapshot and vault. This service is now available in preview for your backup pleasure. You remember Windows CE? The compact edition of Windows meant for portable and headless devices that was released in 1996 and discontinued in 2013? Yeah, that one. Surprise, surprise, it is still being used on tons of devices. At Microsoft Build 2019, Microsoft announced support to migrate from Windows CE to Windows 10. That was a long time ago in tech terms, but the solution is now generally available. Technically, this isn't Azure news, I know, but the data from all these devices end up in the cloud most of the time. And having a modern platform running the device means you can take advantage of all of the delicious Azure IoT services available. And speaking of delicious, this is the end of the show. I'm going to eat my 100th show celebration cake now. Mmm, delicious. Just cut that in a minute. You can't stop laughing. As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, when your entire team asks if you have to host the next 100 episodes too, seek and you shall cake. Cloud! Cloud! So see you next week. Keep staying calm, Cloud Gurus.